Now that a new government has been formed, the issue of universal health care has come to the fore. Former Chief Medical Officer Dr. Stephen King thinks that the UHC needs to be implemented so as to afford every St. Lucian the right to adequate health care. The system, he says, will see the introduction of taxation on certain items, making it possible for everyone to contribute and not just the working class citizens.
What successive governments have said is that really access to health care should be considered a right as opposed to a privilege, which means that every person should have an access to a certain level of health care. And therefore, if you'd say that, then now that led us to the belief that if we're doing that, then that means everybody should contribute. Because if everybody's going to benefit, everybody should contribute. And that therefore moved us towards a more of a tax-based system of financing for our health care.
Dr. King went on to say that certain changes would be in order if the system is to get off the ground. One of them, a change in the modus operandi of the Victoria Hospital.
The management of the health system. So in other words, for instance, should Victoria Hospital remain as a department of the Ministry of Health, or should it be given more autonomy and therefore should it become more of operated by a board which has more authority to manage the hospital? That is one of the concrete changes was that is what should happen. So that's an example. In addition, we spoke about having a more holistic approach to healthcare. So for instance, you may remember the diabetes pilot project where we looked at looking at diabetes as a complete in a complete way, in a holistic way.
Dr. King quoted a Pan-American health consultant as suggesting that at least 2.5% of the proposed value-added tax should be allocated to healthcare. That's in addition to the already existing consolidated funds for health. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.